Okay. I can either kill them one by one, or flood them with cold water. Opening it should flood the bath and get rid of the snakes.
And? Is the bathhouse free of snakes?
I flooded the bathhouse with cold water.
Good riddance!
Well?
Well what?
I took care of the snakes. Now you're going to tell me about the Spartan woman and the baby.
I actually don't know anything. It was before my time. The man who does know is Miven, but he won't tell you. He won't tell anyone anything!
My luckiest snakes. At least I got a name. Miven.
Greetings, young one. Come to offer Asclepios a sacrifice?
No. But I'm searching for a Spartan mother, who may have.
The great goddess Hera guides many mothers to the sacred place. Surely I'm too feeble to remember them all.
What are these stone slabs for?
These are records. We document all who pass through, their illnesses, treatments, so that the glory of Asclepios can be celebrated.
Then I don't need your memory. I just need to find the right stone.
Yes, of course. That's very wise indeed. If only I had the time to help you.
Listen, I'm not here to hurt you. I'm just looking for my mother.
It's Chrysis. She's got every priest in the sanctuary under her thumb, and she'll squash anyone who feeds information to the Eagle Bearer.
Then don't tell me anything. Just bring me to the stone that can.
Follow me then. Quickly. We must be discreet.
Lead the way.
This way. Over here. If anyone is watching, they'll have my head.
What kind of sanctuary isn't safe for its priests?
Times have changed, Eagle Bearer. Ah, I remember this tale, written during the time of the great Elod Revolt. You would have been only a child.
I don't need the history, just the details.
It tells the tale of a woman with worms in her throat. Asclepios took off her head so we could remove them, then reattached it in her sleep.
Definitely not the right one. I wonder what Hippocrates would think of these treatments.
Hippocrates is a fine healer. Showed so much promise.
Showed? He's healing the sick right now.
He puts too much faith in his hands, and not enough in the gods.
When it comes to life and death, I prefer hands. Are all the testimonies so outrageous?
Writers today, Thucydides, Euripides, the petulant Aristophanes, all of them try for realism. But what really inspires is greatness, magic, gods. This one tells the tale of a man with sword wounds. A pack of dogs licked him clean, and Eureka! A man's best friend indeed.
This is hopeless.
These stories give people hope, Eagle Bearer.
Well, I'm losing mine. Tell me about Chrysis.
A very powerful, dangerous woman. But it was not always so. She was abandoned here as a child and taken in by the priests. Taught the ways of the gods. She learned very quickly. Was very strong-willed. And before too long, it was the priests who listened to her. She was loved. But there's an anger in her heart that could not...
And what about this one? Let me guess. It tells the tale of a blind woman who had her eyes licked by snakes.
It reads of Sparta. Came here with child, sought pity from the gods.
Why is most of it scratched out?
I'll just tell you. I know this one by heart. The Spartan woman arrived filthy and bleeding from her travels. We cared for her, gave her food, a bath, and she left. Where she went, I do not know. The child could not be saved.
Who does know where she went?
We've been spotted. Meet me later, near the olive tree of Heracles, at the entrance of the sanctuary. I may have something for you.
And what do we have here? A priest and a mercenary out for a friendly stroll?
May the gods be with you, Plistos. I was just on my way to the archives when this Mystheus bumped into me.
Is that so? And what were you both chatting about so fervently, might I ask?
I'm filthy and could use a good bath. The kind priest here was pointing me in the direction of the bathhouse.
Yes, that's correct. The bathhouse is right over there. Now, if you'll excuse me.
The baths are for healing the sick, not for washing the blood off one's hands. Leave.
Old priest, hiding by the tree. The tree of Heracles? I'm not sure if it's loved more for its legend or its olives.
I thank you for your discretion, Eagle Bearer. Chrysis has many eyes and ears throughout the sanctuary.
What else can you tell me about the Spartan woman and child?
The woman left the child's blanket behind. We tried to return it, but it was too painful a memory for her.
Where did she go? What happened to the child?
So, Chrysis was right. You knew the ruse, Timoxenos. You will suffer her wrath.
Plistos! Please!
Get behind me, priest. I'll deal with these two.
You should have died
Now.
Please help our daughter.
May Asclepius spare her from suffering.
Will she live?
Not unless the gods heed our prayers. Many sick Athenians have arrived in Argolis recently, and very few have left. This poor girl has the same sickness.
Is there anything I can do to help?
I was warned of the Eagle Bearer. Wants nothing but drachmae for blood, I was told.
We're wasting time, priest. We can discuss what I want when this sick girl's needs are taken care of.
Her illness seems to have no cure. And it's spreading. Our sacrifices have done little to draw the attention of the gods. Pigs, goats, all have fallen on deaf ears. We need a beast whose blood will ignite these flames for Asclepius to see.
What did you have in mind?
There is a rumor of a bull with skin as white as snow roaming the sanctuary outskirts. Head west of here, towards the coast. Bring it to me alive, and we'll offer a sacrifice the gods cannot ignore. I'm touched you will help these people, but I know why you're really here. Chryses made all priests swear oaths to seal our lips in the face of the eagle-bearing Mystios, or forfeit our lives. But I serve the gods and the sick. My oaths are to them.
The outskirts are vast. Can you be more specific about the location of the bull?
Last I heard, it was grazing on Mount Corypham, near the Asini ruins.
I'll find this bull for you. Am I too late? Doesn't look like he died willingly. I'll take his heart for the sacrifice. It'll have to do. Not the best feeling. I hope this heart is enough. If they want the whole bull, they can come get it themselves.
you find the white bull?
I couldn't bring it back alive. But I did manage to collect its heart.
This won't be enough to please Asclepios. The beast died unwillingly, and with just a heart, we'll only be able to pray for one life.
Please, Mithios. The white bull you killed was mine. My farm feeds half of our lease. If I die, people will starve.
I beg you! My husband was killed by the sickness. I have two small children. Who will take care of them if I die? I am wealthy and will pay you for this blessing.
It's okay. Give the sacrifice to them.
You did this. You choose whose prayers get heard by the gods.
I know what it's like to be small and forsaken. Pray for the girl.
You regret this!
Not an easy choice, Mistios. But it's been made. The rest is in the hands of the gods.
I did my part, priest.
The Spartan woman you're after.
You've met her?
Her visit to the sanctuary is legendary. But sadly, it was before my time. The man you want is Medon, the elder priest. He spoke of her often. That is, before he cut out his tongue.
Cut out his tongue?
When he's not healing the sick, he's in the guesthouse. Spends a lot of time being tended to by the servants.
Thank you. I won't forget you helped me.
And these people won't forget you helped them.